Hello students, I am Dr. Meenakshi Mao, Assistant Professor, Zoology, Sri Savyaji Government College, Manfia, Chittorgarh. Today my topic is Economic Importance of Arthropoda. So, there are many arthropods which are being used as a food for humans as well as for animals. Crabs, lobsters, shrimps, prawns, and crayfish are very common food for humans. There are many dishes which are prepared by crabs, lobsters, shrimps, and prawns, and it has very high nutritive value. Asian species of horseshoe crab is also consumed by human beings. For animals, mirror stomata like Lamellus polyphemus is sometimes fed to chickens and pigs. Amphipods form a great part of diet for other animals like seals, seagulls, and penguins. Then, arthropods are also being used in many different human meat products. So, first is honey. Honey is produced by bees, that is Apis indica. Bees also produce honeycombs which contain bee wax. So honey and the bee wax are the main products of main production by bees. Honey is honey contains many nutrients. It's a sweet thick liquid. It contains no fiber, fat or protein, and it has a high quality the honey is of high quality, then it is rich in antioxidants. It can help in lowering blood pressure. It also improves cholesterol of the body. There are many beneficial effects on the health by honey. Honey is used in so many dishes. So it is a good source of antioxidants. It has an antibacterial and antifungal property as well. It also helps in healing wounds. It is helpful for digestion. It is also helpful to treat sore throat. So there are many health benefits of honey. Then bee wax, which is also produced by bees. Bee wax is used for making candles, furniture, wax, polishes, wax paper, antiseptics, and filling for surgical uses. The pollens which are stored in honeycombs are also rich in vitamins, enzymes, and amino acids, and they also provide medical benefits. So they are also used as ingredients for supplements and medications, and they also provide relief for cold, asthma, and hay fever. Then, silk. Silk is produced by silkworm, and it is strong enough to use and to be woven into fabrics. Silk is very precious cloth and precious fiber. And it helps the body to retain heat in cold weather while excess heat is expelled in warm weather. So it helps body to maintain a comfortable and natural temperature. And one more thing about silk is that it is a hypoallergenic. It doesn't attract dust mites, and it is a natural fungal repellent. That's why silk is a very expensive. Then the spider web, which is also essential for raw material for Kevlar vest, fishing nets, surgical sutures, and adhesives, because it contains natural antiseptics. So these are human-made products of arthropods. Now, there are many arthropods which are decomposers, because they break down dead plants and animals, and they turn this decayed materials into a soil nutrients. So mites, ticks, centipedes and millipedes, they all are decomposers. And because of these decomposers, the plant gets minerals and nutrients which is necessary for its life and to process its to run its life processes. And it also keeps, decomposers also keeps that material from accumulating in the environment. So it is all, it also helps in waste management. And the plants, through plants, these minerals are transferred to animals because animals eat these plants. So it has a very important ecological importance. There are many arthropods which act as scavengers. Crustaceans like crayfish serve as an agent in the destruction of decaying vegetables and animal bodies in water. Millipedes can dispose of the dead organic matter. Insects are also scavengers. They eat up dead animal and vegetable matter and prevent decay. Some ants and larvae of some flies can also devour entire animals' carcasses. So they help in cleaning the environment. There are so many useful predaceous insects. They feed upon and destroy a large number of injurious insects. Stegomantis, which is voracious, it feeds on flies, grasshoppers, and caterpillars, which are injurious to many, many crops. The larva and the adult of Chilomys, a lady bird beetle, feed on aphids, which infect cotton plant. So these larvae can prevent infection in cotton plants. Novius, a lady bird beetle, destroys scale worms, which are pests of orange and lemon tree. Then Apicuta, which is a blister beetle, it deposits eggs where locusts occur. The larvae on hatching enter egg capsules of locusts and eat up masses of eggs. Callosema, a ground beetle which preys upon many kinds of Lepidopterus larvae, which destroy cereals and cotton. So these are some useful predaceous insects. Any harmful arthropods which can spoil food, they cause destruction to many things, which can be injurious to domestic animals, which can be injurious to crops, which can transmit diseases. So first is spoilage of human food. So human food gets spoiled by cockroaches, ants and flies. There are some cloth moths which can destroy clothes like tinea, tiniola, trichophaga. They lay eggs on warm clothes and the larvae on hatching eat and destroy clothes. They can also feed on furs, carpets and dry foods. Anthrinus, which is a carpet beetle. Its larvae destroy carpets and even can destroy preserved biological specimens. Lepisma, that is silverfish. Lipocalis, that is a book loose, which live in and destroy books and old manuscripts. Termites, that are white ants, they cause destruction to books, carpets, furnitures, and woodwork of ancient or new buildings. There are so many arthropods which can be injurious to domestic animals. Glossina, that is citrus fly, it transmits Trypanosoma brucei, which causes Nagana disease in horses. Tapinus and Stomoxys, which are blood-sucking flies, they inject Trypanosoma evansi into horses and cattle, and this causes Sura diseases in horses and cattle. Then Melophagus, which is sheep tick, and Hippobosca, which is the forest fly of cattle and horses. It sucks blood of cattle and horses and cause hemorrhage. Then Minopon, which is the chicken loose, which sucks blood and cause destruction of fowls. There are so many arthropods which are injurious to crops. They can damage forest trees, they can damage growing farm crops, they can damage fruits, can damage stored grains. And this damage costs annually runs into millions of rupees. So it is a very huge loss of farmers. Millipedes cause damage to plants as they feed also on plant roots and they destroy greenhouses and gardens. Crayfish damages cultivated crops by eating young corn and cotton plants. There are so many insects which transmit diseases. Mosquito is very common. Invertebrate vector. It transmits a wide range of tropical disease, which includes malaria, dengue fever, and the yellow fever. Sandfly species, which transmits the disease leishmaniasis by acting as a vector for protozoan leishmania species. CTC fly transmit protozoan trypanosomes. Trypanosoma brucei gambiens, Trypanosoma brucei rhodesiens. They cause African trypanosomiasis, that is a sleeping sickness. So they can also transmit disease. Arthropods have also ecological importance. There are cockroaches, spiders, mites, ticks, and so many insects which are considered as carnivorous, and they prey on smaller species to maintain ecological balance. There are they act as invaluable agents of pollination. They may be bees, wasps, ants, butterflies, moths, flies, and beetles. And there are other importance, like some arthropods are used for pharmacological, biochemical, and immunological researches. Scorpion venom is used in these researches. In many parts of America, the crayfish, which is soft-shelled individuals, is used as a fish bait. So there are so many important things about arthropods. They can be helpful as well as harmful. So they can be used as a food for humans as well as animals. They are used in so many human-made products. Most common product is honey, honeycomb, silk, spiderweb. They act as a decomposers and keeps dead material from accumulating in the environment and also provide nutrients to plants as well as animals. They can be scavengers. They eat up dead animals and vegetable matter. There are so many useful predaceous insects which feed upon and destroy a large number of injurious insects. In this slide, I have taken so many examples like Stomagomantis, it's a mantis, larva and adult of Chilomins, Novius, which is a ladybird beetle, Apicuta, Telosoma. They are useful predaceous insects. Then there are so many harmful arthropods which can cause spoilage of human food, which can destruct clothes, books, old manuscripts, preserved biological specimens, carpets, furniture, so which cause damages to things, non-living things. There are many arthropods which are injurious to domestic animals, which cause diseases in them. There are so many diseases in humans as well, which are transmitted by insects. There are so many arthropods which are injurious to crops. Then they have ecological importance. They are also being used in pharmacological, biochemical, and immunological resources. Crayfish is used as a fish bait. So this is about economic importance of arthropods. Thank you.